Hey guys, my name is Dr. Sam, and after many requests, I'm going to finally explain all about metformin today, especially what is metformin used for, what is the best way to take metformin, and go over the most common side effects to expect. So many people take metformin and don't realize the common mistakes that can happen when starting this medication for the first time. So I'm really looking forward to letting you in on my behind the scenes metformin tips. So let's go. What is metformin? Metformin is a type of medication called biguanide. Try to say that three times fast. Biguanide, biguanide, biguanide. The generic name is metformin, but it is most commonly known by its brand name, glucophage. What is metformin used for? Well, metformin is a medication that is used to treat type 2 diabetes. Sometimes it is also prescribed to pre-diabetic people or to help women with their fertility if they have polycystic ovarian syndrome. How does metformin work? In type 2 diabetes, the body has too much sugar in the blood, and insulin is the hormone that controls your blood sugar level, but it doesn't work so well in type 2 diabetes. Metformin is quite clever in that it works in two basic ways. So the first one is it reduces the amount of sugar your liver releases into your blood, and the second thing is it makes your body respond better to your natural insulin supply. And while we're on the subject quickly, what is the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes? Well, in type 1 diabetes, the body doesn't make any insulin, so blood sugar levels skyrocket and it can only be fixed with having insulin injections. Meanwhile, in type 2 diabetes, there's often quite a lot of insulin around, but the body doesn't respond to the insulin as well. It's resistant to it, essentially. Later on in the disease, the body stops producing insulin, and often then type 2 diabetics will need to start insulin injections as well. How do you take metformin? Well, metformin comes in different dosages. Normally, it's 500 or 850 milligram tablets. They can be given as sachets and also as part of a combination treatment. Actually, it's really common nowadays to see metformin combined with other diabetes medications, like in Galvomet, for example, which has vildagliptin and metformin in the same tablet together. Also, it's quite usual to be on insulin injections and metformin tablets. Now, I have three tips for you. Firstly, when starting metformin, you should start taking this drug slowly to help with side effects, which I'll talk about soon. I prefer to start my patients on the lowest dose, so one 500 milligram tablet once a day, which is normally taken with your biggest meal of the day, i.e. at nighttime. But you can take it in the morning if you prefer. Then after a week or two, you can increase the dose to 500 milligrams twice daily. And your doctor will want to keep increasing this by one tablet every 1 to 2 weeks. So next you add a lunchtime dose, then adding two tablets at night until you're at a maximum, which is 1 gram 3 times a day. Secondly, take metformin about 15 minutes after eating food. This helps reduce diarrhea symptoms, which are very common amongst people on metformin. Thirdly, I like to get my patients used to testing their blood sugar levels first thing in the morning before you have any food with a finger prick test. This is so you can get an idea of what is happening to your blood sugar levels while on metformin. So basically to give you control back over your health. Does metformin interfere with any other medications? Metformin does interact with some medications, which I'll list in the description, although it's generally pretty safe. I'd recommend to talk to your pharmacist if you are starting a new medicine or want to check if all is okay with your current meds. Is there anyone who should not take metformin? Well, metformin is one of the most commonly prescribed medications in the world, but there are some who should not take this medication because it increases the risk of lactic acidosis, which is when you have too much acid in the blood. If you have kidney disease, have recently had a heart attack, developed heart failure, or have severe liver problems, metformin is not for you. If you are planning to undergo surgery or a radiological procedure that uses iodine, you should stop metformin about 2 days before the procedure happens. What are the common side effects of metformin? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let's get into the nitty-gritty. So side effects that happen to less than 1 in 10 people include feeling sick or vomiting. Remember to take your doses after food, and this usually improves after a few days, but if it continues, speak with your doctor for further advice. The second one is diarrhea, and again, remember to take metformin about 15 minutes after you've had food, and make sure to drink plenty of water to replace any lost fluids. Again, if it becomes severe, see your doctor. Unusual taste, lack of appetite, or stomach pain. Speak with your doctor if these become troublesome. What are the serious side effects of metformin? Well, if you have a skin rash, have trouble breathing, or suddenly feel drowsy, faint, or very sick, please see your doctor immediately, as these can be signs of a rare condition called lactic acidosis. Very occasionally, metformin can cause hypoglycemia or low blood sugar. If you are taking other diabetes medicines, you have done extremely strenuous exercise or not eaten enough food or had too much alcohol. I'll link what hypoglycemia symptoms are in the description for you. Now, I'd like to answer two other questions I get asked about metformin. The first one is, can metformin cause weight loss? Well, actually, it is quite helpful for losing weight if combined with diet and exercise, but it's not a long-term solution, as people typically gain back the weight that they've lost when they stop metformin. What people notice most often is when they are first diagnosed with diabetes and then they start metformin, the weight comes off. And then later when they start insulin, the weight goes back on. The other question I get asked is, should I have a vitamin B12 shot while on metformin? Because everyone is so much more well-informed these days, this question always keeps me on my toes. Metformin reduces the absorption of vitamin B12 and can cause some anemias. Because I'm quite cautious, I like to check B12 levels once a year and do prescribe B12 injections if the levels drop too low. So give this video a like if you enjoyed it, hit the subscribe button for new videos every single week, and hit the bell to get notified when I post new videos on Tuesdays. I've just started making a medication video series, as lots of you have been asking me to talk about your specific medication. So please comment below and let me know what you want to learn about, and feel free to check out my playlist on common medications. I'll see you again soon.